Blink for me, you little... Yeah, that's it. Blink, blink.
I've got a budget Homelab Server PC or SBC for you. You shouldn't miss this one, believe me. I just stumbled upon it, it's like brand new, released few days ago, and let me tell you, it's so wonderful. You won't probably believe me, but stay with me.
Fully functioning Windows, Ubuntu, Debian, Proxmox, TrueNAS, even Windows Server running without a sweat on this thing. And the best part? It starts at 110 bucks and I can get you a discount to lower that price even further. And it fits into my hand. What are you? It's the ultimate budget answer to your Homelab needs. And I emphasize the budget here. If you're not on a budget, you can go and buy the all high-end Dell servers for your brand new rack for tens of thousands of dollars, and you don't need to watch this video. But for the rest of you, us, let me present to you the Youyeetoo X1. I'll just call it X1 down the road. So, what makes it so special? Well, nothing and everything, really. The main point here is that it can do all the usual stuff your PC or server can. Well, besides the high-end gaming, of course, it's still a mini PC. But at the same time, it's really cheap and power-efficient to run. Honestly, my first thought about it was I can run HA cluster on a bunch of these things. But let's do things in a proper order here. So, what is this thing? Well, it's a single board computer, meaning this small device is a whole fully functioning computer. You just plug in your display, keyboard and mouse, and you're good to go. Inside it is a Intel x86 CPU, specifically the 11th generation quad-core Intel mobile processor N5105 with main frequency of 2 GHz bursting up to 2.9 GHz. This is the most ordinary and yet awesome thing about this computer. It's basically an ordinary computer. You can run on it operating systems you would run on your PC or server, but for a fraction of costs. It came pre-installed with Windows 10, so obviously it has enough horsepower to run the usual things like Office, surf the web and so on. Graphics-wise, it's capable of producing output in 4K at 60Hz. To confirm that, I've tested it on 4K YouTube video in Windows 10 without a single frame drop. Well, one dropped frame happened as I was switching the resolution. Interface-wise, you can connect your display or even displays to it via HDMI and micro HDMI ports. And there is also possibility to connect a separately sold 7-inch touch display to it via this MIPI DSi interface. The LCD touchscreen has a lower resolution of 124 by 600 pixels. Thumbs up for three simultaneously running displays. When it comes to RAM, you can buy versions ranging from 4 to 16 gigabytes of LPDDR4 RAM, ranging in price from 110 bucks to 220 bucks, depending on how much RAM you want and how much onboard eMMC storage you want. This was the point when I realized I can probably run hypervisors like Proxmox on it, and I did exactly that. I've got only this 8GB version, but honestly, it's probably enough to run few lightweight containers and VMs. Look, this Neverwinter guy in my quickly built Sword Coast cluster is this little X1 guy. 4 CPU cores, 10 gigs of RAM, and 250 gigabytes of NVMe drive I've got laying around. So, consider this a proven concept. It can be done. You can build a cluster for your home lab and run a bunch of VMs and containers with X1. Sure, you can't compare its performance to some expensive enterprise-grade servers worth thousands, if not tens of thousands of dollars, but that's not something we aim for. If you want to learn more about Linux and Windows servers, and you want to run one or more of them in your home lab, this might very well be an entry point for you. You can build your own Homelab 3-node HA cluster with 12 CPUs, 48 gigabytes of RAM, and 3 terabytes of NVMe storage for, like what, under 700 bucks? That's something. And while talking about the budget, the X1 consumes under full load less than 15 watts of energy, and under average load it's close to 6 watts. That is pretty efficient considering it's no ARM CPU. If we do the math, let's average the consumption to 10 watts. So it's 10 watts times 24 hours times 30 days a month times 12 months a year, coming at 86,400 watts a year. Nowadays, the price here in Europe is something like 0.22 cents per kilowatt. So running X1 for a year will cost you about 20 bucks, depending on where you live and how much the electricity costs. Not bad, right? Okay, but that's just the beginning.
There's so much more you can do with this device. Let me give you a little taste. Staying in the server scope for now. You can turn it into a NAS. TrueNAS is a free and open source solution. This device can have internal eMMC storage, SD card, SATA SSD or HDD drive, and M2 NVMe drive attached to it all at the same time. And you can expand it even further with this M2 SATA adapter and add like 6 more SATA drives to it. And with TrueNAS Scale, which is by the way free, you can build your own storage cluster. I wouldn't use this for some kind of enterprise-grade mission-critical storage, but for your home and home lab, it's perfect. Another great use case is Plex. It's a free streaming platform. You can stream your favorite movies and TV shows from this device to your TV, mobile phone, tablet, or different computer. I'm sure there is a bunch of you who are, same as me, unhappy with the rising number of streaming platforms. Netflix, HBO, Disney+, Apple TV+, Prime, Spotify. How many are we supposed to pay for? To be clear, I am not promoting piracy, but I'm just damn sure there is a couple of you with movies and videos on your external drives that you want to stream to your other devices. You know of whom I speak. It's you, and it's you. And the X1 is here for you to help, capable of streaming your content to the whole house or your whole family. Heck, you can make it safely available from the outside world and stream your favorite TV shows or videos while you're traveling, for example. Okay, let's leave the server scope. What else can you do with this thing? You can turn it into a retro gaming console. I've just hooked my old PlayStation controller to it, installed RetroPie on top of the Debian, and voila, you can play the best old titles you remember enjoying maybe decades ago. Look, Pokemon, Castlevania, Doom, you name it. Check out the RetroPie project. Links in the description. I felt really nostalgic while testing this stuff. Oh, the memories. I remember the first time I played Doom. Gosh, I couldn't sleep for nights. I was so scared. Anyway, if you're like me and play with a lot of devices and operating systems, you know the pain of going through a bunch of USB thumb drives looking for the right one you need just now with the right operating system. There's a solution to this. Check out this tool called Ventoy. I use it all the time. By now, it saved hours of my life, seriously. It creates a special USB thumb drive for you. You copy all the ISO images of the OSs you use often to this one USB drive. And when in need, you just plug in this one USB thumb drive to your computer, and at boot, it will let you choose which ISO image or which operating system you want to boot. Different versions of Windows, Linux, Clonezilla, TrueNAS, whatever you might need. You name it, everything you would ever need. They're not sponsoring this video, I just love this tool so much, I needed to tell you about it. Moving on. Let's have a really close look at the Youyeetoo X1. This is the upper side without the heatsink and cooling fan. It's 115x75mm or 4.5x3 inches. In the center is the Intel N5105 CPU running at 2 GHz base frequency, being able to burst to 2.9 GHz in single core frequency. It's not the latest nor the fastest CPU today. It was in fact released in the first quarter of 2021, I think. But its price to performance to power consumption ratio is still very solid even today. Honestly, I would choose something like Intel N100 today. But that's sadly not an option. Maybe the manufacturer will surprise us in the future with a newer model. GPU chip on this thing is Intel UHD graphics running at 450 MHz base frequency, while being able to burst up to 800 MHz. And maximum RAM supported by this chip is 16 GB. Okay, look at the rest of this board. It's like a parade of interfaces and connectors. Let's start from the obvious. 1 gig Ethernet port, 2 USB 2 ports, 2 USB 3 ports, fan connector, GPIO pins, SPI, I2C, and 3 UART interfaces. 2 4-pin USB 2 connectors, LED connector, speaker connector, power button, audio jack, HDMI 2.0 port, 2 activity LED lights, power connectors for 12 volts and recommended 3 amps, reset button, microphone, micro HDMI output. These two are connectors for PoE or power over Ethernet, micro SD card slot, and this is connector for NFC antenna. I think this is the only SBC I know of that is NFC enabled. It can be kind of a big deal for some use cases. All the peripherals are available at Youyeetoo's shop and you can get it for very reasonable prices. And when we flip it over, there's even more. M2 M-key slot for NVMe and SSD drives. Connector for RTC or real-time clock battery. Microphone M2 E-key slot for the Wi-Fi/Bluetooth module or 4G module. Over here is SATA connector. You can buy an adapter for this flexible printed circuit ribbon cable to standard 2.5-inch or 3.5-inch SSD for like 10 bucks. And the last one is MIPI display serial interface for connecting that 7-inch LCD touch display I mentioned earlier. Oof, that was quite a list. I'm pretty sure the answer to the question which interfaces should we put on this thing was yes. Okay, we can clearly see that in its heart, X1 is a development board, providing you with as many options as it can to build all kinds of projects. In my view, this is one of the most versatile SBCs I've come across with, that you can turn into almost anything in your home lab. I'm quite curious how well it will stand in the test of time, in terms of durability and overall quality. But for now, I must give this SBC a thumbs up. If you have any more questions about this device, don't hesitate, just shoot them my way in the comments below. I do my best to answer all of your questions personally while I still can. As promised, you will find a $5 discount code down in the video description. Go grab it to save a few bucks. As always, if you do find my videos helpful, please hit those like and subscribe buttons. Thank you.